You see, that's the thing. If it becomes no, hold on. I'll tell you all about it. I'll tell you the tafsir of the verse as well.
Okay.
Okay. Al-Qurtubi. In fact, this verse is called Ayat al-Mukataba. It's a verse which talks about Mukataba. Mukataba, chapter 24, verse 33, is the idea that at the time of the Prophet there were slaves. Yeah. This is well known. How can the slave, if you don't mind, Al-Qurtubi says in his tafsir that a slave, yes, or a prisoner of war, because really what they were prisoners of war. They weren't really slaves in the conventional sense of racial slavery or anything like that.
Yeah.
They were prisoners of war that were captured by armies. Those individuals that were in homes, the surah, according to Al-Qurtubi, says, or the verse says, that slave or that prisoner of war or that, whatever you want to call him or her, can demand that they be freed. Now, if the person, Al-Qurtubi goes on to say, if the person, i.e. the slave master or the owner or the boss, says no, yeah, there's one condition, in Ali Mafihim Khaira, if there is good in them, according to Al-Qurtubi, if they're not criminals, they will be bypassed by the judicial system in the Islamic State, and according to the Islamic discourse on the tafsir, that slave can basically become free. So in other words, this is a good example, this verse. Let me finish. This is a good example, this verse, chapter 24, verse 33, of how Islam helped abolish slavery in a way that Christianity could never do that. Because, I'll tell you why, in a nutshell, hold on. In a nutshell, Islam allowed those who were held under captivity, yeah, to be able to go to a judge and say, I don't want to be a slave anymore, I'm going to ransom myself to the slave owner. And then the slave owner, according to the most popular opinion that goes back to Umar ibn al-Khattab and Anas ibn Malik, the slave owner is compelled to let go of that slave.
Okay, so Hassan, he's saying that actually that verse.
And it says in the verse, and do not let your woman into prostitution. So it's the opposite of what you said.
That verse actually allows Muslims to free their slaves.
So no, that's not what I'm saying.
It forces slave owners
to let go of slaves if the slave wants to. Now, if the slave wants to and he draws a contract of ransom, it's called Mukataba, and you can check the verse in Tafsir. According to what he says, it's called Mukataba. If the slave wants to be freed, and this slave is an enemy tribe, and now he says, look, I want to be freed, so long as there's no criminal allegations and there's good in that slave, then according to the most popular opinion that's narrated by the Sahaba, the companions, the slave owner, yes, must free the slave whether he likes it or not. This according to me. No, she doesn't know. I know. So you ask her. It's not going
to
make sense. Look. She doesn't know. I do know. So I'm going
to.
I'm educated. This is edification. Look. If you don't mind, let me
clarify.
So what this is, mukataba. In this sense, this could be said. This could be said. This mukataba could be said in and of itself as an evidence that Islam, number one, its objective was to free slaves,
okay.
And number two, that it did so in a way which Christianity could never do.
Brilliant.
Can you respond? So, I am amazed the way you treated your scripture. That is disgraceful. Let me read the verse for you.
I'll read it out for you in Arabic.
Just a moment. I'm going to look at the Quran and then see what Quran says, and then I'm going to comment on that.
I haven't got a problem reading it for you in Arabic.
Let those who find not the wherewithal for marriage keep themselves chaste until Allah gives them means out of His grace. And if any of your slaves ask for a deed in writing, give them such a deed. If you know any good them, you give them something yourself out of means which Allah has given to you. Here's the problem. Problem comes in here. Force not your slave girls into prostitution.
Force not.
When they desire to keep chastity.
Maybe English is not good. Seriously. Maybe the English language is not strong for you. Because force not means don't force. Yes. You were saying that Islam says go and put your girls into prostitution. It says in the verse, force not. So it's the opposite. So would you like to apologize for that?
Can I have a little bit respect?
Would you like to apologize for that?
As we are talking, I'm reading, I haven't finished the verse yet. Okay.
Yeah, but would you like to apologize for misrepresenting my scripture?
She doesn't need to apologize.
Would you like to apologize?
Because you haven't finished the verse.
Do you want to apologize?
Let me finish the verse.
Okay.
Do not compel your slave girls into prostitution.
Yeah, do not compel.
When
do not.
Desire to keep chest in order.
Yeah.
Seek the trial good for this world's life. And
so you said let's put them into prostitution.
Surely, after their compulsion, Allah forgives them. Allah can
forgive. No, it's not forgiving the girl, not them, not him.
It's the girls.
It's about the girls. Forgives them,
that,
not you.
But yeah, if you do that, Allah
No, the English language is
no,
not.
No,
the
it's bad, very bad.
No, no,
bad.
Go ahead, go ahead. Go on. No, no, it's self-explanatory. The verse is self-explanatory.
The verse says don't do that. If it's done, Allah is unforgiving.
Yeah, of the woman, of the prostitute.
For woman.
For the prostitute.
Of the woman they got through that.
You brought the issues of slavery. Jesus never had a slave. Muhammad had slaves. Jesus never told anyone. It's all right while their husband died. Please continue to
Jesus never had a slave. Jesus never had a slave. Jesus never had, okay. Let me show you something interesting. Let me show you something interesting.
She wouldn't let you.
First, it sounds...
Okay, Hatsun, are you going to let me speak?
Quran, it's, no. You spoke that I'm responding.
Okay, so finish that.
Surah
30 seconds.
24 verse 23 says, don't do that.
No, no, no. Give her 10 seconds. Go ahead. No problem.
And the commentary, there is commentary kind of says, obviously, the verse is forbidding the vile practice of slave owners who prostitute female slaves and pocket their proceeds. And no less offensive the words, Allah after their coercion. It's forgiving and merciful mean that Allah pardons slave girls for having unwillingly committing fornication. From the words, however, is
what's the problem?
Such they can be taken to mean that God is forgiving and compassionate to men who prostitute their female slaves.
Well, who's saying this?
So,
who's saying this?
This comes from the commentary from...
Who? Where is it? Where is it?
Where is it? You don't even know that?
What's that? Let me see what... Where is that? What's that? That's no reference.
It's
okay, that's your own word.
For the Surah 24.
So what, you've just written that yourself or what?
Hudson, can we have... Respond to that.
Yeah, okay, let me respond to that, yeah? Now, she said that Jesus never had a slave. Jesus was the author of the Old Testament. Because according to the Christian faith, Jesus is God. Okay, he's the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, all of them are a collective unit. In the book of Numbers, chapter 31, verse 18, he says, go into the city and take basically the slave girls, the young girls, as slaves. So not only did Jesus allow slavery, but he commanded to it according to the biblical discourse. So don't give me that. Now going back onto for the children, for the young girls. Yeah. Now that's according to the Palestinian Talmud. It's according to I've got a whole video on this. You can go back on it. And all of the exegesis say that this is young girls that can be taken for the sexual purpose. Yeah. Now, having said that, that's Numbers 31:18. Going back to the point about mukataba. I'm sorry, I don't usually say this in debates, so I don't like to say this to people. But here, you guys said that Islam forces women to prostitution, right?
Yeah.
That's what she said. Yeah. Now, she read the verse and she said in a loud voice, do not force your whatever it is I'm not sure, the slave girls to prostitution. Okay, your captives. It should be captives, isn't it? Do not force your captives into prostitution. Okay. If English language, let me finish. Do not force them into prostitution. If English is not your first language and Arabic is not your first language, and now you're reading, do not.
No, but hold on,
guys, please. Let me finish. If English is not your first language, which but it's clear that it's not, yeah. And Arabic is not your first language, which once again is very clear that it's not. Now hold on, I'm speaking. So what I'm saying is that if it's not your first language and you're reading an English text and you don't understand the text because of language barrier, it's unfair for you to come forward and proclaim in front of everyone that the Quran says something which actually is the opposite of what you're claiming to be the truth. Now, at the end of the verse, it says that he is to them forgiving. In other words, because Allah, there's a principle in Islam, which is لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها, that Allah does not overburden a soul with more than it can handle. So in other words, if a prostitute or if a captive is being forced, she's not going to get a sin for that because she is not someone who has decided to do it.
Allah forgive her.
But Allah forgives it for her, not for the person who's putting it. put an omelet.
I've read that, but my understanding is that Allah is saying that it do not force people into prostitution. However, if you force people into prostitution, Allah is merciful and forgiving.
No, that's
to the girl. To the girl.
To her.
That's what it says.
To the person.
No, it doesn't say that.
No.
So read it again.
You got it wrong then.
So you can't read English or Arabic. I will just accuse you of illiteracy. I will just have to accuse you of illiteracy. You can't understand the language.
Whoever compels them, then surely after their compulsion, Allah is forgiving.
To whom?
Yeah,
to whom? Give it to whom?
After their compulsion, he is forgiving.
I'm going to move this on because
that's a misunderstanding of English. No. Forget about Arabic. You don't understand English. You don't get English.
Would you say that Muhammad's example promotes having sex or rape or whatever with young girls? Would you say that? Because that's the accusation we would make.
So it depends on how you define a girl. So the thing is, for us as Muslims, let me be honest with you right here and right now, what we say is that there are three things that determine puberty, in Islam. For a woman, there are four. Number one is the menstruation. Number two is when there is pubic hair in certain regions. Number three is when the person reaches the age of 15. These are things which, if any one of them happen, according to the Islamic discourse, the person becomes pubescent. Now, is it possible for there to be someone who is 15 and hasn't gone through puberty? Yes, it's possible, just as in this country the age of consent is 16. And so someone can be 16 and not go through it.
When did Muhammad have sex with Aisha?
So according to Bukhari, it's nine years old.
Okay, so logically, I'm saying that logically, I would think if Muhammad is the best example for mankind, that means, and he's the best example for all time, that means it's okay if I'm a Muslim man.
Do you disagree with that?
I'm saying. So what is your response? I would say that if someone that is supposed to be the best example sleeps with someone as you agree at age nine, then that means that gives me as a Muslim, if I'm a Muslim man, that gives me the authority to then sleep.
No. Let me tell you why. Actually, it's with this situation, the scholars have attached it to something called aqaida. And it's not puberty. This is a wrong thing Muslims say. I will correct it now, The principle is not when the guy or when the girl becomes pubescent that she can then have intercourse. That's not what we say. Our principle is that it's based on the hadith, which is a general hadith which says لا ضرر ولا ضرر, that there's no, you can't harm anyone and you can't be the cause of any harm to anyone else. So in other words, from the Islamic perspective, it's not puberty that determines when someone should have intercourse. Let me finish. It's according to Islamic discussion, it's actually the principle of harm. So harm, when we say harm, in the society that we live in, if you ask me, in this society in the 21st century, if I go to year 5 class, and I take out a 9-year-old, would it harm her for her to be in a sexual relationship? I will say yes, it would harm her. Back in the days, that might not have been the case because of different sociological, anthropological reasons. Now, so it's contingent upon that which is definable as harmful. So if the person, and by the way, in the Islamic model, we also have expert testimony. So here, in this country, any doctor will tell you that for the most part, having sexual intercourse with maybe a 12-year-old is gonna harm her. So we would say, since that is the case, and because you asked me a question, you need to have a full answer. So since there is harm attached to it, in today's society, we can't do it. And also there's the law. There's the law which we have to abide by as well, because it's the country law. Now, having said that, that's the reasons why we would say. Now, you can have someone who's 16 years old, who's gone through puberty, who has not gone through puberty. You can have a 15-year-old who has not gone through puberty. You can have a 14-year-old who has not gone through puberty. And these are ages in the West of consent, 14, 15, 16. Now, in Islam, in that case, it would be haram to marry those individuals because it would still harm them.
Right.
Do you get me?
I get your point. So, what he's saying is that it's a principle of harm, number one, and this principle of
it's not puberty. Not puberty.
So, as long as you don't force harm.
Okay. So, I guess your prophet was disagreeing with you. Let me look at the couple.
I said, different societies have different standards. That's what I said. So, I don't think he would disagree with me.
Jabir bin Abdullah. When I got married, Allah supposed to say to me, What type of lady have you married?
And what's this got to do with grooming anyways?
I have married a mongrel. He said,
yes.
Why don't you have a liking for a vulture?
I'm happy as well.
And start funding them. Jabir also said,
so you haven't mentioned anything about the Bible. I've mentioned numbers. Why don't we talk
so
about that?
You can play with her.
So you don't want to talk about
it? Why didn't you marry a
Because I've answered your question.
So you can play with her.
Yeah. No, but anyways, I'm hoping that... Look, I don't want to cut you off. You said 20 minutes. Now we've gone over the 20 minutes because I've told that guy over there that I'm going to speak to him, yeah?
Do you want to hear about the Bible?
No, if you want to speak about the Bible, I'll give you a minute to do it now.
Yeah, numbers.
Numbers 31:18. How can you justify that there's a command from Jesus to go and rape the young girls?
Who come to that? Have you finished your point?
No, don't just come to her. I'm giving you the time now. I'm giving you a chance.
She's going to try to avoid that now.
I'm giving you a chance.
I'm making a point.
Yeah.
Because Islam gives no view to the woman. Therefore, Pakistani Muslims grooming is all right. And the way you are talking to me, just confirm that yes, Islam does give no view to the non-Muslim woman. Let me respond to the numbers. Numbers 31.
I didn't hear you say that.
Yeah.
Okay. They were the ones who followed the Balaam's advice and were the means of turning the Israelites away from the Lord. In what?
Get her to read it, please, so everyone can understand.
That the blood starts to
She's destroying the English.
Now,
can you read it
all the
so everyone can understand it?
And kill every woman who has slept with a man, but save for yourself. Every girl who never slept with a man.
So what are we going to do with
all of you
play games.
Who have killed anyone or touched anyone who was killed must stay outside of the camp 7 days.
Yeah, so what should we do about
on
that? Should we take that out of the Bible?
7 days, you must purify yourself and your captives.
Okay.
So,
I love
let's,
to write that.
Let's
so
say, the Bible. No, I haven't finished, man. Hold on.
Be honest.
Yes, yes.
Let's go for it.
Yeah.
Let's say what they need to do with those virgin girls. Every girl who never slept with a man. You go to the Deuteronomy.
Let's go to the exegesis. Why should we go there? It's all there.
Why
should we go to everyone?
21, which tells you what you need to do with those virgin girls.
Okay.
When you go to the war against your enemies, and the Lord your God delivers
what verse is this? What number?
Into your hands.
What number, William?
And take your captives. If you notice, among the captives, a beautiful woman are attracted to her, you may take her as your wife. Bring her into your home.
So you're allowed to take the young ones for your wife?
Yeah.
The young ones.
Shave her head. Trim her nails. Make her shave her head. Trim her nails. So you look after her.
Read verse 10. Read verse 10.
You look after her.
Read verse 10. Read verse 10.
And put aside the clothes she was wearing when captive. After she has lived in her house and mourn after her mother and her mother for a month. So when you take the slave girls,
the young one, yeah?
You looked after them. You give them time for
Read Deuteronomy 21:10. Read this. Read 21:10.
Yeah, 21:10.
You give them time to mourn for her father.
Read
21:10.
Warn.
Then,
to warn, yeah.
Kill her and be her husband.
What do you mean, no father? The Bible.
She shall be your wife. She shall be your wife.
Even she's young. Even she's young.
Force marriage.
Wherever she wishes.
Okay.
You must not sell her or treat
any
her
last
as your
words?
Slaves. Since you have dishonored her. This is the very verse actually. Confirms Muhammad cannot be prophet because introduction given to the prophet Moses. Yet, what did Muhammad do for me?
Anyways, any questions? Any final remarks?
Sir, did Muhammad fulfill this promise when
Why would he need to? It's corrupted, miss.
Okay, so within
a
summer
right now. It's corrupted.
Again,
any questions?
Any questions?
All right. Give a very low view of non-Muslims. That's very disrespectful, sir. You are very disrespectful.
Take care, bye.